Good morning. Good morning. If we could have everybody's attention. Good morning. What an exciting day for Appleton and the Fox Cities. Thank you so much for joining us on this special occasion. My name is Matt Baumler with Lawrence University, but it is my privilege to turn the program over to the president of Lawrence University, Laurie Carter.
Thank you, Matt, and thank you to all who are present for joining us for this very special moment in the history of the university and our community. At Lawrence, we are committed to academic excellence and student outcomes. And we are continually seeking opportunities to build on the academic tradition that for 177 years has made Lawrence one of the finest liberal arts colleges in the nation. We continue to adapt our academic and co-curricular programming and experiences to prepare our graduates for a rapidly changing world. The true power of this partnership is in the traditional and applied learning opportunities that will happen within this new building. When it opens in the fall of 2025, the building will provide our faculty and students with innovative academic spaces that will enhance teaching and learning in the humanities, the arts, mathematics, computer science, and data science. It will provide new opportunities for our students to engage with community partners through internships and other collaborations as we prepare the next generation of thoughtful, inspired leaders. Today, we celebrate our Board of Trustees for their bold investment in academics and the student experience. We celebrate the brilliance of our faculty who will bring life and purpose to more than 30,000 square feet of state-of-the-art academic space. We celebrate our deepening partnership with this community, most notably with the Trout Museum of Art, an indispensable jewel in this community. As we celebrate Lawrence's place in this vibrant community, when we built the arch you see across the street in 2022, we said it represented an entryway to campus, a welcoming nod to the community, a connecting point for Lawrence and downtown Appleton. Our histories are forever entwined, and today we add another chapter, deepening our investment and commitment to downtown Appleton. We would not have been able to realize our commitment without the support of someone who has dedicated his life to uplifting this community. John Bergstrom, Lawrence University was proud to confer upon you an honorary doctorate, and we are even more proud to have partnered with you in a way that allows us to live out our values as stewards of place. Thank you. Thank you for your leadership. Guidance and determination to move this project forward in a way that benefits us all. To Christina Turner, thank you for answering my call and for opening the door to this transformative collaboration. Finally, thank you to Mayor Jake Woodford, who has graciously joined us today. As a 2013 graduate of Lawrence, we are proud to claim you as a Laurentian. This beautiful collaboration with new academic spaces, a new home for the Trout, and a reimagining of the East End of downtown is moving us all forward in important, impactful ways. I speak for the entire Lawrence community when I say thank you for sharing this special moment with us. To work in partnership on this transformative project is truly a joy. I would now like to introduce Susan Hall, a 1976 graduate of Lawrence, the parent of a 2012 graduate, a longtime friend of the university, and a member of our Board of Trustees. Susan.
Thank you, Laurie. I am delighted to be here today. This is an amazing day. Look at all the people. Look at all the blue in the audience. It's absolutely exciting. On behalf of the Lawrence University Board of Trustees, I would like to thank Laurie, the university's cabinet, and the Trout Museum's team for all the work that has been completed to get us to this groundbreaking ceremony. For more than 50 years, Lawrence has been a very important place to our family. I graduated in 76. I went on to business school right after that. I had a 10-year career in business. While I liked my career in finance, I was not passionate about it. And I was lucky enough that our oldest child had trouble learning to read when he was in first grade. And that led me to my passion. So I became fascinated with why are so many children not learning to read in our schools. I completed a second graduate degree, this time a doctorate in education, and I'm so lucky I got to co-found with my husband a company to work on this huge problem in America. We created a company that provides assessments, curriculum materials, and professional development for teachers in elementary schools in our country. It is my education at Lawrence that enabled me to do those things. I was able to change careers and work on one of America's most challenging societal problems, and it's because of Lawrence. Our daughter graduated from Lawrence 36 years after I did, and she also went on to get her first graduate degree, and I have hope that she too will find her passion, change careers, and maybe start a venture herself. So our family is very grateful to Lawrence University for preparing us to achieve our goals and our passions in life. It's great to be here for this groundbreaking. The trustees believe that this is much more than a building. It's a critical piece of our university's future. Thank you.
Distinguished guests, artists, faculty, students, and supporters. I'm Christina Turner, the Executive Director of the Trout Museum of Art. Welcome and thank you for joining us today as we embark on a groundbreaking journey. The construction of a new art museum in collaboration with our esteemed Lawrence University. This moment marks the convergence of academia and art, where the boundaries of knowledge and creativity combine to create something extraordinary. Art has always been a profound reflection of the human experience, an expression of our hopes, our struggles, and our aspirations. And now, with this partnership, we have the opportunity to elevate that expression to new heights, blending the academic rigor of Lawrence University with the boundless creativity of the Trout Museum of Art. The museum will serve as a vibrant hub for intellectual exploration and cultural enrichment. It will be a place where artists can thrive, where ideas can flourish, and where new forms of art can be born. As we stand here on this hallowed ground, we are reminded of the transformative power of art, and it has the ability to inspire, to challenge, and unite us. And it is this power that will be at the heart of the new museum, a place where visitors from all walks of life can come together to explore, to learn, and be moved by the beauty and richness of the visual arts. None of this would be possible without the dedication and support of Dr. Monroe and Sandra Trout, the museum's namesake and generous leader. We deeply mourn the loss of Dr. Trout this week, whose unwavering commitment to philanthropy and art has left an indelible mark on our community, and we forever cherish the legacy of generosity he leaves behind. Acknowledging our community's collective effort, we extend our gratitude to so many individuals and organizations, to our team leader, John Bergstrom, our partners, President Carter and Lawrence University, Kathy Tierney and Community First Credit Union, Pam Seidel and the Fox Cities Visitor and Convention Bureau, Kurt Deachin and the Community Foundation for the Fox Valley Region, the Wisconsin Energy Foundation, Bolt, Fred Fisher and Partners, Mayor Woodford and our city officials, local artists, and everyone who played a role in bringing this project to life, the museum's board and staff, offer you our deepest thanks. Your generosity and vision has turned this dream into a reality, and we are eternally grateful for your support. As we break ground today, let us look forward with anticipation to the day when the museum's doors open, a place of discovery, of inspiration, of endless possibilities. Together, let us build a future where art and education intersect, where the creativity knows no bounds, and where the pursuit of knowledge is fueled by the power of imagination. Thank you once again for being part of this historic moment. Together, let us build something extraordinary. Thank you. And I would like to introduce Karen Cain, the Trout Museum of Art's board chair. Thank you, Karen, for being here.
Thank you. Thank you for inviting me to say a few words about today's groundbreaking ceremony. Not only are we putting shovel to dirt today, but we are also launching a truly groundbreaking partnership. With generous supporters and an excited community by our sides, the Trout Museum and Lawrence University have taken this bold, groundbreaking step in arts and education collaboration in the Fox Cities. For 177 years, with excellence as its goal, Lawrence University has prepared students for enriched lives by encouraging meaningful citizenship, lifelong learning, and personal fulfillment through education. And we, who represent the Trout Museum of Art, are proud to stand side by side with Lawrence University to blend with and build on these shared values. The Trout Museum acknowledges that art is crucial to understanding culture, history, and values, and encouraging the mindset of lifelong learning. With these lofty goals in mind, TIMA has built a robust education program, offering year-round classes and welcoming participants of all backgrounds, skill sets, and lifestyles. Take a class at the Trout Museum. Get immersed in our exhibits, share in our excitement, and support our goals of being lifelong learners. Stand side by side with us and Lawrence University as we embrace the synergies of education and art and look forward to all that we will achieve together. Thank you.
Thank you. Well done. Is this a cool community or what? Huh? This is exciting. President Laurie Carter placed a call last summer to Christina Turner saying that she believed that it would be in Lawrence's best interest and the community's best interest if we all worked more together. She suggested that working as partners, we could build a new Trout Museum of Art in conjunction with the needs that Lawrence had in their expansion plans. That call was the genesis of this location and this beautiful new facility. All of us that were fortunate enough to know Dr. Monroe Trout and his gracious wife, Sandy, will miss him and their stalwart support for this community. Last Thursday night, Christina and I met with Dr. Trout and Sandy and gave them our commitment that this facility would be everything they dreamed of. We're presenting them with a picture we had made of an artist's rendering that generated out of Dr. Trout's mind what he expected this to be. He had a smile on his face. He was happy. And he didn't say it, but he wasn't looking forward to a groundbreaking experience in 35 degrees in the wind in March in Appleton. But he and his wife, Sandy, let us not forget, made this all possible. I can also tell you that without the masterful work of Kurt Deachin, putting their dreams and our community's need and all of the little challenges that come along, it wouldn't have happened without his masterful ability to get things done without offending people. For those of you that know me, he has to come behind me quite a bit and clean things up. But the reality is, he does an amazing job, and the Community Foundation is an incredibly important part of this activity and many activities that go on in this community. We have 97% of the money in the bank to build it, so we don't have to worry about having a mortgage payment or who's going to pay for what. Tom Bolt and his organization are going to start later today to transform this site into an amazing building. 120,000 square feet, $40 million, quality state-of-the-art stuff that will transform this little corner, which is the link now between our community and Lawrence that President Carter dreamed of. I don't think that any of us ever wants to overlook the important part that Christina Turner has put in this. I'm reached a point in my life I can pretty much say what I want, and people can get mad later. I've watched this thing since it started. I watched it go into an old furniture store. I watched people try to make it into something. And it sputtered up off and on for that whole period. Then Christina showed up. Since then, she has been unbelievable in her ability to go get people to understand how important art is to their community. She knocks on doors. She's knocked on my doors enough times that I recognize the knock. And my secretary, we both hold her in high respect, say, how much is it going to cost to get rid of her today? But the reality is, it's that can-do attitude that has driven the Trout to making sense every month and not having a cataclysmic financial situation every 90 days. So I give her terrific credit. There are days where we go toe-to-toe, but I want her to know, and I want her family to know, how much she is an important part of making this happen. Another thing that not many people know about, but is critically important, is 14 years ago, Oscar Bolt called half a dozen of us, and he said, we're going to get together at Mark's East Side Friday at noon. See you there. Anybody else that does that might say, what are you doing Friday at 12 and whatever day? But that wasn't Oscar. And all six of us showed up, sat around a table, had fish at Mark's East Side, with every person in the place coming up to say hi to OC, the leader of our community. And he explained to us how important it was that we got going and built this new Museum of Art. He also had that glimmer in his eye that was taking it away from maybe something we could do to a little bit, let's get our act together and get it done. He and Walt Ruglin, who was always there in the background trying to help him and keep it a little smoothed over sometimes if it got rough, had the same vision that we're executing today, in that this was not a building we were going to have that was kind of okay for a museum. It was going to be at a level that we could all be proud of and that would bring people here to our community and make it even stronger, bring key employees to our companies, and provide an educational center for young people in the arts that we all needed. So, Oscar, you and Dr. Monroe should be doing high fives with St. Peter today, because you stuck us with the project. Now we got to get it done, and we will. I promise you. So I'm going to apply for a permit with Mayor Jake, which he will say is better than what I normally do. And we're going to have fireworks here on the 4th of July, in the coolest new building in our community for a long time. So, Mayor Jake, just sign it and don't look for the rules, okay? And there was a guy that doesn't say much, except for in our meetings, that has been the link between the Trout Board and those of us in the community that are trying to lead the effort to get it done. His name is Clint Dusenberger. Never knew him before. I got to tell you, he's made life so much more fun. And he and Christina have done a great job, because some of us in business don't understand why it takes so long for people in the arts business to go from point A to point B. I have seen the two of them so much that I know they have 23 pairs of sunglasses, okay? But I can tell you, Clint was an important part, because he was that go-between that we needed. So collectively, everyone here today plays a part in this. But collectively also, for Dr. Trout and Sandy, let's all say thank you for the important gift that he gave us all, and we're going to make him proud. God bless you all.
Good morning. It is so good to gather together in community, and I appreciate all of you being here for this exciting occasion here in the City of Appleton. I'm Mayor Jake Woodford, and on behalf of the City of Appleton, it's my privilege to bring you greetings. This is an exciting day for our community as we break ground on yet another incredible arts and culture venue here in the City of Appleton. Now, I'd be remiss if I did not pause for a moment to reflect on the extraordinary life and contributions of the Trout Museum of Art's namesake and benefactor, Dr. Monroe Trout, who passed away earlier this week. Dr. Trout and his wife, Sandy, have left an indelible mark on Appleton and the Fox Cities in so many ways. And this project is a testament to their commitment to improving the lives and opportunities of all people in the community. While it is sad that he cannot be here in person to break ground on this project, I am certain that he's with us in spirit, joyful as he was in the twilight of his life at the good works he was so willing and able to support. Thank you, Dr. Trout. Now, this project is so special in many ways, not the least of which is the incredible pace with which it has taken shape. You might think that a project that's evolved over the course of a few years isn't fast, but when you consider that so many projects in Appleton and the Fox Cities have marked their development in decades, this project has moved at a blistering pace. And there's someone behind that. This is in thanks to the visionary leadership of Lawrence University President Laurie Carter, Trout Museum of Art Executive Director Christina Turner, their boards and campaign committees, and dedicated community leaders like John Bergstrom and Kurt Dachin, and so many others who've been named already. Together, they have, through deep partnership, created a vision and a plan for a new home for the visual arts in Appleton, and an even stronger presence for the university in our downtown. And I thank them for their collaboration and their leadership. As mayor of the City of Appleton, I am truly heartened by the ways our community institutions, organizations, philanthropists, and citizens work together to improve the quality of life and access to arts, culture, and education. Today is a reminder of the blessings of living in a place like the Fox Cities, and we truly are blessed, and the importance of continuing to push forward and invest in what makes community, community. Congratulations to Lawrence University and the Trout Museum of Art on this momentous occasion, and we're just about ready to get after it and break ground. So thank you again, and congratulations. And next, I'd like to welcome up LUCC President Anders Hanhan, class of 2024. Anders.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Anders Hanhan. I'm a senior here at Lawrence University and the president of LUCC, which is our student government here at Lawrence. As a student who came to Appleton to get a liberal arts education that demonstrates the importance of cross-disciplinary work as a primary focus of my education, I am so excited for the new West Campus collaboration between Lawrence and the Trout Museum of Art and what it means to the community of Appleton. The Trout Museum is a key part of Appleton, a place where Laurentians like myself love spending time visiting the changing exhibits, taking a workshop class that the Trout has offered to the Fox Valley community over the years. While I'm graduating this year, I know that this collaboration will bring exciting opportunities for the generations of Laurentians to follow me. The West Campus building will become a shared center for the Lawrence Humanities Program. It will house a digital humanities lab that will integrate technology into academic programs that will radically change the way that students engage in research. Imagining the opportunities that our arts and humanities students at Lawrence get to experience while working in collaboration with our Trout Museum partners is incredibly exciting and has limitless possibilities. This building is another example of what makes Lawrence and Appleton distinct and exemplifies the importance of experiential learning in a liberal arts education. As a political science and environmental studies student, one of the main reasons I came to Lawrence and came to Appleton was to be able to participate in a rich and diverse conservatory while not making music my primary area of study. The expanded space for our conservatory in this project is a fantastic opportunity to better connect the Lawrence Conservatory with Appleton's rich culture of music. From Mile of Music in downtown Appleton to orchestra concerts at Lawrence's Chapel, music is such an important part of the relationship between Lawrence and Appleton. Finally, our second floor will also be hosting a space for a Center for Statistics, Mathematics, and Computer Science, which will assist our students in the classroom and better prepare them for success with life after Lawrence. This is a perfect opportunity for the various academic departments at Lawrence to mix and mingle with conservatory students on a daily basis, offering incredible cross-department collaborations and enhance the liberal arts opportunities for students, faculty, and staff. Finally, this project is a great symbol of a bond forming between Lawrence and Appleton, bursting what we call the Lawrence bubble, and creating a truly collaborative community, which is why I couldn't be more excited about West Campus and our partnership with the Trout Museum of Art. Thank you all.
Thank you. Now the moment you all have been waiting for. It's time to break some ground.